Hey, everybody, it's Beth. Happy Easter. This is the month we get to celebrate that God is a redeemer and a reconciler and a restorer and a repairer of things that are broken. And because he did that first with us, we now get to represent him in a world to people who don't have any understanding of how he feels about them and how he's in pursuit of them. I was telling my kids the other day at dinner, they can't really conceive of a world where we didn't have GPSs or cell phones. And I was telling them when I was 16 and first got my license, I was working at the amusement park Kings Island here in our hometown. And after work one day, a bunch of the people I work with were going to go to someone's house and have a party. And I'd never done anything like that, but I kind of sounded like fun. And I wasn't sure my parents would let me. So I told them I was going to another one of my friend's houses to spend the night. And I followed these crew members from our ride to one of their houses. And I now know we drove from where we were in northern Cincinnati over to the edge of Indiana, and we crossed into the Indiana state line. And I was at the party maybe 10 or 15 minutes, I don't know, not very long. And I realized pretty quickly, this isn't something I'm gonna wanna be at all night. And I was kind of feeling uncomfortable and out of place. And I decided I was just gonna go back home. But no one else was ready to go home. We just literally got there. So I got back in my car by myself and I just retraced my steps to get back on the highway. And I felt pretty good. I was on the highway heading back to my house. But there was this point where the highway split and it said that I could go one direction to Cincinnati or another direction to Columbus. And I thought, well, I'm pretty sure I live in Cincinnati, so I'm going to follow that road. And as I followed that road, it wasn't too long before I crossed over a bridge into Kentucky. And at this point, I'd now been in three states and I knew I was nowhere near where my house was. And I had no idea how to get home. So I finally pulled over to the side of the road and found a payphone. And I called my house and I told my dad where I was or where I thought maybe I was and what had happened. And I waited because I just thought he would be mad or he'd make me feel bad. But really all he said to me was, hey, stay on the line with me for a minute. I'll lead you home. And when I was telling my kids, I'm like, oh, you guys, he was just a human and he loved his daughter, but he is just a shadow reflection of who God is. And sometimes we get lost in life and we think something sounds like a good idea. And then we realize, you know, that probably doesn't sound like a good idea. And we try to retrace our own steps and we end up getting lost and we have our own metaphorical three-state trip on a bad night. And when we finally decide, I don't know how to get back to where I need to go, and we decide to call him and reach out to God, we have the same kind of fears I had that night on the phone call. We think he's going to be mad or he's going to make me feel bad. But the way that my dad acted that night, again, just a reflection of the heart of our Father who's just waiting for us to call him. And God says to us, stay on the line and I'll lead you home. That's all he wants, is for us to reach out. Then he does all the rest of it, literally all the heavy lifting. And this month, the reason he does all the heavy lifting is because he decided to come and dwell among us. And there, here among us, he lived and died and conquered sin and death. And we celebrate this month what happened 3 days after he died on that cross. And then really what we celebrate is what happened 50 days after that, right? If you go all the way back to the story of Moses, you remember that story in Exodus chapter 32? It's like after the 10 commandments and Moses comes down and they all have that golden calf. And instead of waiting on, trusting for what God had for them next, they decided to take matters into their own hands, something that we can often do and find ourselves lost because of it. And when they took matters into their own hands and screwed up things royally with that golden calf, worshiping something of their own hands instead of someone that they could trust like God, Moses got real mad. And you can read the story for yourself. He tells one of the tribes to get on one end of the camp and to strap a sword to their waist and to run from one end to the other. And it says on that day that 3,000 people lost their life. Like, how tragic that sometimes our choices, when left unredeemed, can literally cost a life. If you fast forward, you know, Jesus came and dwelled on earth and had his ministry and was nailed to a cross on Good Friday, and 3 days later was resurrected again. Then 50 days later, left the Holy Spirit for us in something we call the day of Pentecost. In Acts chapter 2, when that day of Pentecost came, you know, those tongues of fire came and rested on their heads, and people were understanding things in a way they hadn't ever understood them before. Those who accepted this message were baptized, and 3,000 people were added to the number that day. And I don't think God made that number up. I don't think he was like, well, let's just do 3,000. How about 2,500? I think he was sending a direct message to his church that no matter what choices that we have made, he will redeem the things that have been lost. He will reconcile and repair the things that have been broken. He is for us and he is coming for us. And we get to carry that message around in the world this whole month. That's what we get to celebrate and trumpet about. Before the golden calf, right? When the Israelites were still trying to get free from the slavery that Pharaoh had them under, God used all these plagues to get their attention, to get Pharaoh's attention so that he would let his people go. And one of the plagues I just can't stop thinking about is Exodus chapter 10. It's called the plague of darkness. And it says that darkness fell so thick around them that they could actually feel it. And I don't know if on one of those nights when you found yourself in three states you shouldn't have been in on your way home, after having done something you shouldn't have done, like lie, if you felt surrounded by darkness so thick you could feel it. But it says in there that even the darkness was so thick that they could feel it, that among God's people, light was always among them. And I just want you to use your like Disney Pixar brain for a minute and imagine a world where things are really, really dark, but that everywhere that God's people went, they had light with them, like they were little human lightning bugs. Like, what does that look like? And I think this month, that's the thing we celebrate, that no matter where we go, there is light among us, that we can be on any road, on any path, in the middle of any choice, good or bad, and God is right there with us, ready to lead us home.